In this video, we'll take a look at the AI-assisted grading and manual answer grouping tools, which are part of our Gradescope Complete product. Let's go to the Grade Submissions tab and click on a question. We select form answer groups first, and now we're prompted to mark the question type. This question is multiple choice. We click Review Answer Groups, and Gradescope's AI processes all of the student submissions into groups of similar answers. Here, the AI found 6 groups. If we want, we can give each group a title, merge it with another group, or delete the group. Let's click and double check that all the answers are the same. So this group looks good, and we confirm. If there was an answer that didn't belong, we would just hover over it and press the space bar to remove it from the group. Let's go through and confirm all of our other groups. All right, now all of our groups are confirmed. Here we see the one answer that we removed earlier. We can assign this answer back to the correct group by clicking and dragging it. And now we're done grouping, and we can click Grade Answers. We see that we're now grading the first group, which has 4 submissions. Groups will appear in order of group size, with the group that has the most submissions appearing first. Here we see a sample answer from the group. If we wanted to edit the group, we could click on the group name here, and if we wanted to view all the submissions in this group, or grade any submission separately, we could click on Submissions here. This answer is partially incorrect, so we mark that accordingly. Now, when we click Next, that rubric item that we just created is automatically applied to all the other 3 submissions in Group 1. We can now go through and grade the rest of the groups. And that's it. With only a few clicks, we just graded 20 submissions. Let's try grouping and grading another question. This question is a fill-in-the-blank math question, where students wrote a mathematical response in a fixed answer region, like a box or line. Here, the AI sorted all student answers into 2 groups. If the groupings ever seem inaccurate, we can improve the AI's accuracy by editing the location of the final answer area, which would reprocess the groups. In this case, however, it seems that the AI did a good job, and we can quickly review these 2 groups to confirm. Now that we've confirmed those 2 groups, we can see that there were 4 answers that couldn't be grouped. We can drag and drop this 20 into group 1, and we can put these 2 blank answers into a new group. Let's leave this one answer ungrouped. When we click Grade Answers, we'll see that we'll be grading 3 groups, followed by 1 ungrouped answer. So we can quickly go through and grade. Here's that one ungrouped submission at the end, and we're done with this question. Finally, if we want to grade a question that does not match one of the suggested question types, such as this geography question, we can select manual grouping. We can now look through all the submissions and group similar ones together ourselves. So let's select all the ones that have South Dakota shaded, then click Create a Group and give it a name. Let's create a few more groups. From the Edit menu here, we have the option to edit the group name, merge 2 or more groups together, or delete a group. And that's it. Once we're done grouping, we can proceed to grading each group just as we did earlier.